electric locomotives and rail freight sector livery. This brief introduction will go through the startup and stop procedures. The rear locomotive is already running with its tail lights on and its handbrake released. Climb aboard the lead locomotive to get started. A lot of time will be spent driving, so take a seat to continue. The master key. Set the... Go ahead and start the locomotive. With the handbrake holding the locomotives, set the train brake as indicated. The main reservoir will take a moment to charge. This can be observed by watching the brake dials. Lights and a head code are in. It's time to move. Set the handbrake as indicated. Increase the throttle to start moving. Do not apply too much power to it. With the train now moving, it's possible to apply more power and focus on achieving the desired speed. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain a constant speed. Make use of the brakes and throttle controls to manage the train and prevent overspeeding. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive.
What on earth is this? What on earth?
Welcome to this Class 101 three-car diesel mechanical multiple unit in British Rail blue and grey livery. This brief introduction will cover startup, stopping and passenger operations. Before getting started, some of the controls must be set in the rear cab. Head over and climb aboard. Red lights are used to signify that this is the rear of the operational train. While the brakes in the lead vehicle hold the train, set this brake as indicated. Everything's now set up, so head to the front of the train to continue preparations. When ready, sit in the driver's seat. The control circuit key is used to activate the driver's desk. White lights will indicate to anyone around that this is the front of the operational train.
Right.
This train features two engines in each driving vehicle. Start the engines in this vehicle. Now start the engines in the rear vehicle. Give a quick glance of the platform to ensure. It's time to move. Set the handbrake as indicated. The brakes on this train act like a water tap. The higher the setting, the faster the train will stop. Open the valve to select the desired pressure, then close it again to maintain that pressure. Increase the throttle to start moving. Do not apply too much power too quickly. It's important to provide a smooth ride for passengers. The process of changing gear has several steps. Set the throttle to idle and allow the engine RPM to reduce below the yellow zone.
Yeah.
Engage the new gear, then return to the desired throttle application. Let's try. Observe that the train now has the ability to accelerate to a higher speed. When the RPM dial reaches the top of the yellow zone, repeat the gear change process to continue accelerating. There's a short distance between here and the next stop, so be sure to manage the train and prevent overspeeding.
Yes, it would be nice.
To cruise at a constant speed, the highest gear should be engaged. This reduces the speed the engine operates at and is fuel efficient.
direction south and Prince Man Gap.
Stopping a train in the right place is the greatest skill of a driver. It may take a few attempts to get it right. The brake control on this train opens a vacuum, releasing pressure holding the brakes off the wheels. To maintain a specific pressure, close this valve by setting the handle to the lapped position. Aim to be doing no more than 15 miles per hour when the train reaches the platform, then come to a stop anywhere alongside. Start applying a small amount of brake force now to achieve a comfortable stop. Good work. That's the basics covered. A manual can also be obtained that provides more detail about the full functionality of this train and more. Welcome to this Class 08 diesel-electric shunting locomotive in BR Corporate Blue livery. This brief introduction will go through the start and stop procedures. Before entering the locomotive, the battery isolation switches. Enter the cab and continue. Active lights are important to let others around know this locomotive is operational. A lot of time will... Go ahead and start the locomotive. Now that the engine is running, the master switch needs to be set. The main reservoir will take a moment to charge. This can be a... To ensure that nothing moves while preparations continue, adjust the locomotive brake accordingly. The locomotive brake is holding the train, so the rest of the brakes can be released. The reverser. Track alignment plays a large role when maneuvering around a yard. Head out on foot and adjust the indicated junction as required. It's time to move. Set the locomotive brake as it. Increase the throttle to start moving. With the train now moving, it's possible to apply more power and focus on achieving the desired speed. Use of the brakes and throttle controls to manage the train at a better the stop marker, apply a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable stop. Good work. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive.
What the heck just happened there then? Well, that's a bug.